Hello, and welcome to the presentation on independent control of AI engine partitions. In this tech module, we will start with an introduction to AI engine independent partitioning. Next, we will cover the AI engine kernel workflow, detailing the process of compilation, linking, and packaging. We will then dive into modular control over partition management and reloading, discussing the flexibility it offers for efficient development. After that, we will go through key system considerations, highlighting what's available and the limitations to keep in mind. With the release of 2025.1 Vitis tool, a significant improvement has been made to the way the AI engine array is handled. Now, the AI engine array can be partitioned to run independent partitions, which means you can manage and run each partition separately. This enables a simplified workflow for compiling and running each partition independently, leading to greater flexibility and modularity. Modular capability means that you don't have to recompile partitions repeatedly. Once you have the kernel compiled, you can manage each partition individually at runtime. This is a major enhancement because it gives runtime control over the partitions, allowing users to dynamically manage and control them according to the needs of their application. The AI engine array needs to be partitioned based on the specific user requirements. This provides more fine-grained control over how workloads are distributed across the system. By handling each partition separately, users now have modular control, making the development process more efficient and flexible. Let's explore a powerful and efficient method for managing AI engine resources through independent column-based partitions. This is achieved by creating independent graphs that can be compiled and simulated separately. Each graph is assigned to a specific column or a contiguous block of columns in the AI engine array. Once compiled, the V++ linker combines these partitions, ensuring no overlap in resource usage, a critical aspect for maintaining a stable and efficient design. Finally, the V++ packager prepares everything for deployment, combining the compiled partitions and the host application into a ready-to-run package. By leveraging this partitioning approach, you gain greater control, scalability, and performance in your AI engine applications. When managing AI engine resources with column-based partitions, there are a couple of key things to keep in mind. First, partitioning can affect cascade interfaces, limiting communication through PLIO or GMIO. Next, it is important to ensure that the PS does not interact with other Versal AI engine partitions during the process of reloading a partition. Let's now look at how AI engine kernels are compiled in the context of independent partitions. First, you define partitions using the given enable partition format. These partitions are passed during compilation with the V++ command line using the given command. This tells the compiler which columns of the AI engine array to use for a specific partition. For example, enable partition equals 6:2:PR0 means the partition PR0 will occupy columns 6 and 7. Each partition is compiled separately, and the same graph can be reused across different partitions if mapped to different columns. The compiler will generate separate outputs like libadf0.a, libadf1.a, etc., one for each partition. It's crucial that partitions don't overlap. If they do, the V++ link stage will report a conflict error. Also, if you don't explicitly define a partition, the graph will assume control of the entire array, which can unintentionally conflict with others at link time. Partitioning ensures clean separation, better resource usage, and modular design. After compiling the kernels, we proceed to the V++ linker stage. Here, you will need to create a linker configuration file. This file contains the connectivity details for your kernels, specifying how they interact with each other and with the rest of the system. Running the linker with the .cfg file generates an .xsa file. The .xsa file represents the complete hardware design and is required for the next step in the workflow. The next stage is the V++ packager, which takes the .xsa file and your host application binary, host.exe, as input. The V++ package command is called to merge multiple compilation results together. The host application is responsible for managing the lifecycle of the AI engine kernels. It should initialize, run, and terminate each kernel as needed. This separation ensures that each partition is managed independently, even though they might be part of the same system. The V++ package command is called to merge multiple compilation results together. For Linux systems with a fixed XSA, be sure to include the given commands in the V++ packager command. Packaging takes all the linked binaries and puts them onto an SD card image. It's important to preserve the order of the libadf.a files because it influences how data is organized and how the runtime behaves. Now that we've seen how the packaging process is handled, let's understand what this structure really enables. By separating the PL-only XCL bin and AI engine-only XCL bins for each partition, we're adopting a modular and flexible deployment strategy. This means we no longer need to repackage the entire system every time a single AI engine graph changes. Instead, we can compile, package, and deploy just the affected partition, saving significant time and improving development efficiency. In this process, we use a configuration file, package-pl-only.cfg, to generate a flat XCL bin containing only the programmable logic bitstream, isolating the PL resources for specific applications. Additionally, AI engine overlays, libadf.a, are packaged separately into independent XCL bins, each corresponding to a specific partition. For example, PR1, PR2, and so on till PRN. The example codes demonstrate the V++ packager commands for generating PL-only and AI engine-only XCL bins. A key feature here is the use of package.defer-AIE-run. This defers AI engine execution, allowing us to control when and how each graph is loaded and run at runtime. This opens the door to dynamic graph management, where different graphs can be loaded based on system conditions or workload requirements. By organizing AI engine overlays into separate XCL bins, like PR1.XCL bin, PR2.XCL bin, etc., we can easily manage and scale larger applications. Each partition becomes self-contained and independently deployable, making the system more modular, scalable, and maintainable. This approach leads to faster iterations, easier debugging, and better runtime flexibility, all of which help maximize performance and productivity in AI engine-based systems. With incremental AI engine compilation, we only recompile the modified parts of a graph using AIE.OutputArchive. This produces smaller, faster builds, ideal for iterative development. Each partition generates its own incremental archive, which is then packaged into an XCL bin using package.AIE_overlay. We still use package.defer-AIE_run, so runtime control is preserved. Incremental AI engine compilation enables faster build cycles, modular updates, and preserves runtime control for efficient and flexible development. While incremental AI engine compilation streamlines the build process, by focusing on only the modified parts of the graph, the new partition reload flow takes this efficiency a step further by enabling independent, targeted reloading of specific partitions. As we see in the flow one, the entire application had to run, complete, and then exit before performing a full reload of the entire system for any updates. This could be inefficient and time-consuming, especially for large applications. Now, with the flow 2, with new partition reload, we gain significant efficiency. Each partition is treated independently, and only the targeted partition is reloaded while the rest of the system continues to run. This reduces the overhead of reloading the entire application and allows us to focus on specific parts of the system. The flow 3 involves using C++ new keyword to dynamically allocate objects such as the XCL bin, hardware context, graph, and kernel. These objects can be deallocated using the delete keyword before reloading the XCL bin. Here we will see how the local scope functions works, described in flow 2. As we see here in local scope 1, we first execute the graph for the partition PR2. Wait for the PL kernels and graphs to finish, then move on to local scope 2, where we reload the partition with updated configurations. The rest of the system, including other partitions, remains unaffected. This dynamic reloading allows for faster iterations and improved control over the application. This approach enables efficient partition management, allowing targeted reloads and avoiding the need for a full system reset, leading to faster iterations and better resource utilization. Here, we will see and compare using the AI Engine array in both single and multi-partition configuration modes and when each can be beneficial. Let's start with the single partition approach, where the entire AI Engine array is treated as one single partition. You should use single partition when independent reloading of graphs is not required. It's good to use when AI Engine resources are limited and must be used efficiently, and when you want to avoid the complexity of managing multiple partition images. In contrast, the multi-partition approach divides the array into smaller, column-based sections. This approach is particularly useful if you need to independently reload multiple graphs. This approach is suitable when resource usage is not a primary concern and offers great flexibility. It's very handy during initial design or debugging phases where you want to isolate and test different parts of your design. The multi-partition approach gives developers more control and flexibility, making it a great option for complex projects that demand modularity and rapid iteration. Now we will go over the key considerations and limitations when working with independent AI Engine partitioning control. AI Engine partitioning is based on columns, with each partition using exclusive resources. This isolation can sometimes lead to performance inefficiencies. When reloading a partition, it's important to ensure that the PL does not send any data through AXI stream or access the AI engine via AXI memory mapped. This prevents unintended data transfer during the reload process. Additionally, you must manually reset the Vitis region along with all PLIPs that interact with the AI engine to clear their states. And the data samples currently in transit within the PL should be flushed to avoid any data corruption. It is important to ensure that the PS does not interact with other Versal AI Engine partitions during the process of reloading a partition to maintain system stability. When performing a reload, only the targeted AI Engine partition is affected. The user is responsible for managing system-level error recovery to ensure smooth operations. Vitis Analyzer, while a valuable tool for debugging, also supports event tracing is specific to each partition. HDL and AI Engine co-simulation is not supported when partitions are enabled. It's important to note that bare metal support for these features is still limited or in beta, so users should be aware of this when planning for deployment. Here is the summary and the key benefits of the enabling independent control and optimized management of AI Engine partitions through AMD Vitis Unified Software Platform. AMD Vitis 2025.1 allows independent control of AI Engine partitions, improving resource management and isolation. Partition reloading impacts only the targeted partition, minimizing system disruption and enhancing uptime. Performance is optimized through column-based partitioning, avoiding resource overlap for stable operation. Users have full control over partition reloads and error recovery, allowing tailored system optimization. Debugging tools like Vitis Analyzer provide detailed insights at the partition level. The system is scalable and designed to support more complex applications in the future, ensuring flexibility, control, and performance for developers. That should wrap up this video. Thank you.